Hey folks, this is Gabe with Security Barrett, and today we're checking out the best VPNs of 2019. Now, if you'd like to read today's review of the best VPNs of 2019, Google Security Barrett Best VPNs. In today's Best VPNs of 2019 video, I'm going to give you my top picks in 6 categories, check out their respective subscription options, and finally give you the key to my methodology so that you can make the right decision for you. All right, let's kick things off with our pick for best all-around VPN, which goes to ExpressVPN. Now, ExpressVPN has a strict no data logging policy, so they're not gonna hold on to your specific user information, your browsing history, your web traffic, or your IP addresses. And when it comes to using ExpressVPN, you can do split tunneling. So you can be on both a public network and a private network. So that helps you to, you know, reduce your bandwidth usage. And don't worry, you can get on Netflix on both. So yes, ExpressVPN is one of the rare VPNs that actually works with Netflix. Now, combine that with the fact that it has amazing ratings in both the Apple App Store and Google Play Store, and you really start cooking with fire. Now, on top of these things, it has great customer support, which is also not the most common of things in the VPN game. And if you add that to the fact that you can use it on Mac, Linux, Windows, Android, iOS, gaming consoles, you really get a lot of longevity and use out of the ExpressVPN. So when it comes to a best all-around VPN, we're gonna go with ExpressVPN. All right, let's jump into our next category for best VPNs. Windows, and our best Windows VPN is Private Internet Access, also known by its acronym PIA. Now, when it comes to download speeds on my Asus VivoBook, PIA did really well, only increasing the time by 15%. And when it comes to upload speeds, it did even better in my case, going up 5%. And when you look at the latency or ping, it only increased it by about 30%, and these were the fastest times of any VPN on my Windows computer. Now, of course, PIA does really well in other categories with its strict no data logging policy, capability to work with Netflix, and just a general intuitive experience on the mobile application. But when it comes to Windows, there is no peer. We give it to PIA. All right, let's jump into maybe one of our most fun categories for best VPNs of 2019, Netflix. Now, when it comes to watching Netflix, you're gonna wanna use NordVPN. Now, I'm especially looking forward to watching Stranger Things season 3 later this year, and I know I'll be able to do it with NordVPN because it has one of the most consistent experiences when it comes to servers that allow you to access Netflix. So you should be able to just binge to your heart's content right through that NordVPN. Now, when it comes to other qualities, it also has them, and they're positive. Like the fact that it's based in Panama. So in Panama, you don't have to worry about it being a part of any of the international surveillance organizations like Five Eyes or Nine Eyes or 14 Eyes. So you can feel a little bit better about your information not being handed over to some government entity or, you know, government agency, maybe not even from your own country. So that's something to think about with NordVPN. And overall, it's our pick for best Netflix VPN. The next category that we're gonna go over in our best of VPNs 2019, we're gonna go with sharing. And the best VPN for sharing is Windscribe, because sharing is caring and they take that to an extreme level. It's something we've learned since kindergarten, but you know, most VPNs, they only give you 3, 5, maybe if you're lucky, 10 simultaneous connections. But Windscribe said, no, we're gonna go with unlimited simultaneous connections, unlimited server switching, unlimited connections to any device. And that is very impressive. It's unprecedented, frankly. And they're doing it. So Windscribe definitely believes in sharing between family members, friends, whatever you have, you can do so with Windscribe. So that's something to keep in mind, along with the fact that they actually are a pretty secure VPN. They do something called a double hopping, which means they put your information, your web traffic, through two separate servers anytime that you're using their VPN. So overall, when it comes to best sharing VPN, we're going with Windscribe. The next category for our best VPNs of 2019 is best VPN for torrenting. Legally, of course. Now, for that, we go with FastestVPN. Now, it's in the name, and they are one of the fastest VPNs out there. And if you want to torrent, you can do so. Not only that, but when you torrent with FastestVPN, you could do it with up to 10 devices at a time. So yeah, if you want to have all your computers circling around you and you're just torrenting from one to another, you can do so because it does that with that 10 simultaneous connections, which honestly is a lot more than many of the other VPN companies out there that usually give you between 3 and 5 simultaneous connections. Finally, it is also one of the more affordable VPNs out there. It allows you to actually do a contract for less than $1 a month, which is pretty impressive considering its other stats. So when it comes to best VPN for torrenting, we're going with FastestVPN. The final category that we're gonna go over today in our best VPNs of 2019 is what's best for your Mac. And for us, it was CyberGhost. Now, not only is it a cool name, but when it comes to the speed, CyberGhost does really well. When I was downloading things on my MacBook Air, my speed decreased by less than 3. Uploading, less than 8%. And when it comes to the latency or ping, it was 14%, which is mighty impressive. Now, CyberGhost, of course, has other things going for it, like the fact that it's based in Romania. And in Romania, you don't have to worry about an international surveillance organization coming into play. It's not a part of Five Eyes, Nine Eyes, 14 Eyes, so you're pretty good in terms of government entities demanding to see your data. So when it comes to using a VPN with your Mac, we're gonna go with CyberGhost. All right, hold on, quick break. I hope you're enjoying today's video on the best VPNs of 2019. If you'd like to read our full written reviews of each of these VPNs and more, check them out on securitybaron.com. All right, let's get back to the video. All right, now that we've gone over our top picks for each category in best VPNs of 2019, let's look at the subscription options and simultaneous connections afforded to the user, because it's really important that you know how much you're paying and how much you're going to get out of each VPN. All right, let's begin by checking out our best all-around VPN, ExpressVPN. Now, for $12.95, you can get 1 month of ExpressVPN. If you decide to go a little bit longer, for $59.95 or $9.99 a month, you get 6 months. And the most affordable plan for ExpressVPN is their year-long deal, and that's gonna break down to $8.32 a month or $99.95 a year. Now, with each of those subscriptions, you get 3 simultaneous connections, which is a little bit on the low side when it comes to options for most VPN companies. Now, one thing we can say is that it gives you 30 days to try it out. So you can try ExpressVPN, take your time, and if you decide within a month that you don't really like it, you can get your money back. Next, let's check out our best Windows VPN, Private Internet Access. Now, if you go with 1 month, it's gonna be $9.99. If you go with a year, it's gonna be significantly cheaper at $5.99 a month or $71.88. Now, if you decide to go for 2 years, it only goes up to $83.87 or $3.49 a month, which is pretty affordable if you ask us. Now, with each of those subscriptions, you're gonna get 10 simultaneous connections, which is about the average in the VPN world. But just remember that you only get 7 days to try it out, so 7-day money-back guarantee with private internet access. All right, let's check out the pricing for the VPN with which you should be doing all that Netflixing, NordVPN. Now, let's break it down monthly. If you go with 1 month with NordVPN, it's gonna be $11.95. If you sign up for a year, it's gonna go to $6.99. If you sign up for 2 years, it drops all the way down to $3.99 a month. And if you go with a really impressive 3-year commitment, it's gonna be $2.99 a month. Now, with each of these subscriptions, you get 6 simultaneous connections. And for each of these, you get a 30-day money-back guarantee, giving you ample time to check it out and see if it's the right VPN for you. Next, let's jump into Windscribe, our best VPN for sharing. Now, Windscribe has some pretty interesting configurations when it comes to pricing options. Now, you've got your pretty straightforward basic $9 for a month or $49 for a year, which breaks down to about $4 a month. But you could also do a custom plan, choosing your own servers, which actually can get your price down to $1 per month, which is pretty much unseen. Now, when you're looking at that, you have to remember that you get unlimited simultaneous connections. So with Windscribe, you don't have to worry about having 3, 5, 10 connections. You can just put every computer you've ever had online at the same time. Now, there is a bit of a price to that in that the money back guarantee for Windscribe is 3 days. So something to keep in mind when looking at Windscribe. Let's check out FastestVPN, our best VPN for torrenting. Now, if you decide to go with a month, it's $10. If you decide to go with a year, it's $29.95 or $249 a month. If you decide to go with 3 years, I know that says six, but if you decide to go with 3 years, it's $39.95 or $1.11 a month. And if you go with 5 years, it's only $49.95 or 83 cents a month, making it one of the most affordable VPNs out there. Now, with that, you get 10 simultaneous connections on up to 10 devices. And honestly, where are you gonna put all those devices? I mean, that's pretty impressive, pretty solid number for a VPN on the market today. Now, one thing to remember is that you only have a week to try those out with its 7-day money-back guarantee. So that's what's going on when it comes to subscription options and simultaneous connections with FastestVPN. Finally, let's check out our best VPN for Mac, CyberGhost. Now, 1 month of CyberGhost is $12.99. If you decide to sign up for a year, it's going to cost you $71.88 or only $5.99 a month. 2 years, even cheaper. It's going to be $369 a month or $88.56 up front. And finally, if you go with that 3-year commitment, it's going to cost you $99 or just $2.75 per month. Now, CyberGhost offers you 7 simultaneous connections on 7 devices, which is pretty middling. You know, it's not the least we've seen and not the most we've seen when it comes to simultaneous connections, but where they definitely win today is that money back guarantee. You get 45 days to try it out. You can really sink your teeth into CyberGhost to see if it's the right VPN for you. So that's what we like the most about CyberGhost. The final thing I want to go over today is the methodology I used to go over the conclusions that I came to regarding these VPNs. Now, there are roughly 6 categories that we look at here at Security Baron: speed, security, performance, subscription options, customer support, and mobile applications. Now, when it comes to speed, I test everything in my Brooklyn apartment on the Optimum network using a MacBook Air and an Asus VivoBook. Now, when it comes to security, I basically run WebRTC tests and DNS leak tests. Now, with each of these tests, I'm able to get an idea of how well it's protecting my information, but we try to go beyond that, looking at, of course, where they're headquartered to see if they're part of any international surveillance alliance. We also look to see what their encryption and internet protocol methods are, and we just generally like to see how they're perceived in the market. Now, when it comes to performance, we look, of course, at security and speed, but also, do they work with Netflix? How well can you torrent with them? Can you split tunnel? These are things that are important to consumers and important to us. Now, looking at subscription options, you'll have to think about not only the price, but how many simultaneous connections can one have? And when we look at customer support, we, of course, reflect on our anecdotal experience. But we also try to look at Amazon and Trustpilot to see what people are thinking over the lifetime of the VPN. So not just looking at what happens at the beginning or the most recent, but just see how people generally feel. Finally, we look at the mobile application on our iPhone 10. We also try to see how it performs on, of course, other browsers and systems like Chrome, Firefox, Safari. But that is generally how we go through the process of figuring out what is the best VPN. So that's our look at the best VPNs of 2019. If you appreciated today's video, give us a like and hit that subscribe button. As always, this is Gabe at Security Baron. Be secure.